I mean, you saw this from a mile away years back, and now here we are, and yet it seems that most on the street are still underestimating what this company is able to deliver. What to you do you think surprised many the most from this specific earnings report?
Hey, David and Yvonne, that's a great question. Headline numbers is not actually what moved this stock after hours. It was up, you know, 1-3%. And in fact, at times it was selling off. It was really during the call when management highlighted key points about the Blackwell architecture. So the Hopper architecture is what got us this far. That's $90 billion annualized run rate on the data center. Moving forward, what's going to keep this stock extending? That's what analysts wanted to know. We put a note out prior to earnings that it would be the Blackwell architecture. Now, this Blackwell architecture, just to break it down for you, is the B100, the B200, and it greatly improves on memory. It also has something called NVLink, and there's a GB200, which combines 72 GPUs for one exascale computer. I know that's a lot of semiconductor jargon. It's really hard to avoid that with NVIDIA, but the takeaway is that the Blackwell architecture that is coming will exceed the Hopper architecture that we've already seen drive these sales, and it will hit as soon as Q2, full ramp by Q4. That was stated on the call. That's when you saw the price, stock price reverse after hours.
Can you give us some just your initial calculations of just how it could contribute to earnings? I mean, data centers already make up about 85% of total revenues. Is that likely to continue? Could that ramp up much further?
Yes. So we're really very early to AI acceleration. And so Hopper drove that $90 billion that we see. We are foreseeing a $200 billion data center segment by the end of calendar year 2025. And the management team today insinuated and gave hints that that could happen, because what they said is that Blackwell will deploy with over 100 OEMs, which is two times broader and faster than Hopper, which deployed with 50 OEMs. So if you can imagine, you're hearing all these comments from management on the call, and it's clearly indicating that the Blackwell architecture, the second generation basically of these very high in demand generative AI GPUs, is going to be a step up from what has been deployed. So the translation here is that Hopper gave us $90 billion annual run rate. What will the Blackwell give us? And that's when you started to see this extremely bullish price action after hours. This is a stock that's run hard and fast, and now it's up, you know, 5-6% after hours. People are getting excited to think about how the year will end now that this second release is coming out. And if I can, the other key point here is that NVIDIA is shortening its product cycle from 2 years to 1 year. They've never done this before. It's bold, and it's very important to do right here, right now, because it allows them to continue to grow on top of this already phenomenal growth.
So again, Beth, then, so how far behind on, let's say, on AI accelerators there, how far behind do you think competition is? Give it to us in, I don't know, quarters, if that's a useful yardstick.
In terms of how far behind competition is, the difference between something like NVIDIA and something like AMD is that NVIDIA is definitely the go-to for training. Now, once inference market is built out, right now 40% of NVIDIA's revenue comes from inference. That is where there's an opportunity for AMD to compete. AMD is very good at design, and what they did is they doubled the memory. And so now it's a competition against memory, because you can run the large language models in memory close to the user, close to where the edge basically is what you call it. So now there's a little bit of an opportunity here for AMD to compete with NVIDIA specifically on inference at the edge due to the large memory components that AMD is building in their designs. That's the key to why AMD has a little bit of room to take some of the market. If I were to guess, I would say AMD, by the time this is said and done, let's just say 2030, will have no more than 10 to 25% of the GPU market.
In terms of NVIDIA's revenue growth, though, I mean, that seems to be slowing down and has been decelerating for recent quarters now. Is that going to be a problem?
That's a great question. This is where many investors jump off a growth story, is when you hit peak growth, you see deceleration coming. Where that will be premature for a company like Nvidia is that what we're seeing is organic growth. So it's flowing through to their margins and to their bottom line. And then the other piece is that Nvidia is really an intra-quarter revisions story. So in fact, in November, there was a muted reaction to the earnings report. And then intra-quarter, analysts kept upping their estimates to where the stock now is up 90% since November, even though it sold off of that earnings report. So the reason why all of that is important is because even though it's decelerating in revenue growth, it's fairly valued today. And if we continue to see those upward revisions with Blackwell, very confident we will, you'll start to see the price move up with those revisions. And that's really key because as Blackwell rolls out, the demand is so great that analysts will be revising that, and that's when the price is going to move.
Right. And Beth, as you, I think you pointed out, I think it was 2 days ago on Twitter X, or X, you know, the multiple in the stock is at the same level when the share price was at about 100. So to your point, fairly valued. I'm looking at concentration risk of customers, if I could just pivot back there. I mean, four big customers, the bulk of the revenue, the bulk of the business. Is that a problem?
Today, management discussed that about 40 to 50% is coming from cloud service providers. They also break out consumer internet companies. They also break out companies like Tesla. And I think they're doing that because of the concern that you just voiced. And you are absolutely correct about the valuation, which is that when you have that 300% revenue growth, 600% earnings growth, the valuation is keeps getting cheaper and cheaper, even as the price goes up. So what we've seen is very attractive valuation. And again, that goes back to if we continue to see upward revisions based on Blackwell, very confident we will, that's where those revisions are going to be bought.
Right. Okay, so we're at 1,000 now. What's the price target, Beth?
Give me a year. Next year or 2030?
Give us both.
We have modeled 65%. 65% upside based on Blackwell by the end of 2025, calendar year 2025. By 2030, wow, this company should be minimum $10 trillion in revenue, maybe higher. So we have a long, long runway with NVIDIA.
Right.
This is because we're in the AI economy now. So many people think this is going to end soon. It's not. This is the very, very beginning. Can't stress that enough. Multi-generational investment opportunity. Many Chinese companies are benefiting. Baidu, Tencent, great earnings reports coming from AI. NVIDIA's AI infrastructure, but we're seeing a lot of beneficiaries, and I would encourage people to pay very close attention to that.
Yeah, Beth, just to clarify, you mentioned $10 trillion. You mentioned revenue. Do you mean market cap, or do you actually mean revenue?
I'm sorry, I meant market cap.
Okay.
Gotcha. I was going to ask you about the AI economy because you flagged that Qualcomm. This is an interesting company. You said it could become the star when it comes to AI PCs. Can you tell us sort of what you're projecting?
For Qualcomm, I would hesitate to call it the star of AI PCs because what's going on with Qualcomm is they have an ARM license basically through the end of this year. And so they have a little bit of an open window right now to push forward this ARM-based PC, although they're primarily a mobile company. And so what you'll start to see when that exclusive license runs out is AMD and NVIDIA are prepared to release ARM-based PCs in the first quarter of 2025. I think AI savvy folks looking for an ARM-based PC are probably going to wait for AMD and NVIDIA. They are clearly the de facto companies when it comes to computing power. So I think that Qualcomm has its hands full with competing with the two top design companies in the world.